Gordon always pulled the big express. He was proud of being the only engine strong enough to do so. It was full of important people, like the fat controller, and Gordon was seeing how fast he could go. Hurry, 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 he said. Trickety-tock, 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 said the coaches. In a minute, Gordon would see the tunnel where Henry stood bricked up and lonely. Oh dear, thought Henry, why did I worry about rain spoiling my lovely coat of paint? Will the fat controller ever forgive me and let me out again? I'm going to poop-poop at Henry, said Gordon. He was almost there when... And there was Gordon going slower and slower in a cloud of steam. His driver stopped the train. What has happened to me? Asked Gordon. I feel so weak. You've burst your safety valve, said the driver. You can't pull the train anymore. Oh, dear, said Gordon. We were going so nicely, too. And look, there's Henry laughing at me. Everyone came to see Gordon. Huh, said the fat controller. I never liked these big engines. Always going wrong. Send for another engine at once. While the guard went to find one, they uncoupled Gordon, who had enough puff to slink onto the siding out of the way. Edward was the only engine left. I'll come and try, he said. Huh, said Gordon. That's no use. Edward can't push the train. Edward puffed and pushed and pushed and puffed, but he couldn't move the heavy coaches. I told you so, said Gordon. Why not let Henry try? Yes, said the fat controller, I will. Will you help pull this train, Henry? He asked. Oh, yes, said Henry. When Henry had got up steam, he puffed out. He was dirty and covered with cobwebs. Oh, I am stiff, he groaned. Have a run to ease your joints and find a turntable, said the fat controller. When Henry came back, he felt much better. Then they coupled him up. Peep, peep, said Edward, I'm ready. Peep, 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 said Henry, so am I. Pull hard, we'll do it. Pull hard, we'll do it. They puffed together. We've done it together. We've done it together, said Edward and Henry. You've done it, hooray. You've done it, hooray, sang the coaches. Everyone was excited. The fat controller leaned out of the window to wave at Edward and Henry. But the train was going so fast that his hat blew off into a field where a goat ate it for tea. They never stopped till they came to the station at the end of the line. The passengers all said thank you, and the fat controller promised Henry a new coat of paint. On their way home, Edward and Henry helped Gordon back to the shed. All three engines are now great friends. Henry doesn't mind the rain now. He knows that the best way to keep his paint nice is not to run into tunnels, but to ask his driver to rub him down when the day's work is over. James was enjoying his life on the island of Sodor, but he still had a lot to learn. You're a special mixed traffic engine, said the fat controller. You can pull coaches or trucks quite easily, but you must learn by your mistakes. James knew what the fat controller meant. He could well remember that dreadful accident on his first day. Be careful with the coaches, James, said Edward. They don't like being bumped. Everyone came to admire James. I'm a really splendid engine, he thought, and suddenly let off steam. A shower of water fell on the fat controller's nice new top hat. Just then, the guard blew his whistle, and James thought they had better go. Go on, he puffed to Edward. Don't push, replied Edward. The coaches were grumbling too. Don't go so fast, don't go so fast. But James didn't listen. When at last they stopped at the next station, two coaches were beyond the platform. They had to go back to let the passengers out. But no one seemed to know about the fat controller's top hat, though James felt happier. Presently, they came to the station where Thomas was waiting with his two coaches. Hello, James, said Thomas. Feeling better? That's right. Oh, that's my guard's whistle. I must go. I don't know what the fat controller would do without me to run this branch line. And he puffed off importantly. Edward and James passed the field where James had had his accident. The fence was mended and the cows were back again. They ended their journey and rested before setting off for home. James was still wondering what the fat controller would have to say about his top hat. Next morning, the fat controller spoke severely to him. If you can't behave, I shall take away your red coat and have you painted blue. James didn't like that at all. He was very rough with the grumbling coaches as he brought them to the platform. Don't talk, come on, he called to them. Gordon never has to fetch his own coaches, he thought to himself, and he's only painted blue. To make James even more cross, this time no one came near him. I'll show them, he thought. They think Gordon is the only engine who can pull coaches. Hurry, 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 puffed James. You're going too fast, you're going too fast, replied the coaches. James laughed and tried to go faster, but the coaches wouldn't let him. We're going to stop, they said. We're going to stop. What's the matter? James asked his driver. The brakes are hard on. Leak in the pipe, most likely. You've banged the coaches enough to make a leak in anything. How shall we mend it? Said the guard. We'll do it with newspaper and a leather bootlace, replied the driver. Well, where is the bootlace coming from? Asked the guard. Ask the passengers, said the driver. You have a leather bootlace there, I see, sir, said the guard to a smartly dressed man. Please give it to me. I won't, said the man. Then, said the guard, I'm afraid the train will just stop where it is. The passengers all said what a bad railway it was. Then they told the man how bad he was instead. Everyone was very cross. At last, he handed his laces over. The driver tied a pad of newspaper tightly round the hole in the brake pipe, and James was able to pull the train. But he was a sadder and wiser James and took care never to bump coaches again. James had not seen the fat controller for several days. He was left alone for being naughty and was not even allowed out to push coaches and trucks in the yard. Oh dear, he thought, I shall have to stay in the shed for always and no one will see my red coat again. All because I went so fast I made a hole in one of my coaches that had to be mended with, of all things, a passenger's bootlace. At last the fat controller arrived. I see you are sorry, James, he said. I hope now that you will be a better engine. You have given me a lot of trouble. People are laughing at my railway, and I don't like that at all. I'm very sorry, sir, said James. I will try hard to behave. That's a good engine, said the fat controller. I want you to pull some trucks for me. James was delighted and puffed away. Here are your trucks, James, said Thomas. Have you got some bootlaces ready? And he ran off, laughing. Oh, said the trucks. We want a proper engine, not a red monster. James took no notice and started as soon as the guard was ready. Come along, he puffed. We won't, screamed the trucks. But James didn't care, and he pulled the screeching trucks sternly out of the station. Trucks tried hard to make him give up, but he still kept on. Sometimes their brakes would slip on, and sometimes their axles would run hot, and each time the trouble had to be put right. And each time James would start again, determined not to let them beat him. Give up, you can't pull us, you can't, call the trucks. I can and I will, puffed James. But slowly but surely, he pulled them along the line. At last they saw Gordon's Hill. Look out for trouble, James, warned his driver. We'll go fast and get them up before they know it. Don't let them stop you. So James went faster and soon they were halfway up. I'm doing it, he panted. Will the top never come? Then, with a sudden jerk, it all came easier. I've done it, he puffed. Hooray, it's easy now. But his driver shut off steam. They've done it again. We've left our tail behind. Look. The last trucks were running backwards down the hill. The coupling had snapped. But the guard stopped the trucks and got out to warn approaching engines. That's why it was easy, said James, as he backed the other trucks carefully down. What silly things trucks are. There might have been an accident. Shall I help you, James? Called Edward. No, thank you, answered James. I'll pull them myself. Good. Don't let them beat you. You're doing well, whistled Edward, as James slowly struggled up the hill. I can do it, he puffed. He pulled and puffed as hard as he could. I've done it, he panted. They reached their station safely and James was resting in the yard when Edward pulled up. Beep, beep, he whistled. Then James saw the fat controller. Oh dear, what will he say, he asked himself. But the fat controller was smiling. I was in Edward's train and I saw everything, he said. You've made the most troublesome trucks on the line behave. After that, you deserve to keep your red coat. Henry, James, and Gordon were miserable. They had been shut up for several days for being naughty and longed to be let out again. At last, the fat controller arrived. I hope you are sorry, he said, and understand that you are not so important after all. We have a new tank engine called Percy who helps pull coaches, and Thomas and Edward have worked the main line nicely. But I will let you out now if you promise to be good. Yes, sir, said the three engines, we will. That's right, but please remember that this no shunting nonsense must stop. He then told Percy, Edward and Thomas that they could go and play on the branch line for a few days. And they ran off happily to find Annie and Claribel at the junction. The two coaches were so pleased to see Thomas again. Edward and Percy played with trucks. Stop, 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 screamed the trucks as they were pushed into their proper sidings. But the two engines laughed and went on shunting till the trucks were tidily arranged. Next, Edward took some empty trucks to the quarry. Percy was left alone. He didn't mind that a bit. He liked watching trains and being cheeky to the other engines. Hurry, 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 he would call, and they got very cross. After a great deal of shunting, Percy was waiting for the signalman to set the point so that he could get back to the yard. He was eager to work, but was being rather careless and not paying attention. Edward had warned Percy, "Be careful on the main line. Whistle to the signalman you are there." But Percy didn't remember to whistle, so the busy signalman forgot him. Percy waited and waited. The points were still against him, so he couldn't move. Then he looked along the main line. Peep, peep! He whistled in horror, for rushing straight towards him was Gordon with the express. Gordon, get out of my way! Percy opened his eyes. Gordon had stopped with Percy's buffers a few inches from his own. But Percy had begun to move. "I won't stay here. I'll run away," he puffed. He went straight through Edward's station and was so frightened that he ran right up Gordon's hill without stopping. After that, he was tired, but he couldn't stop. He had no driver to shut off steam and apply the brakes. "I want to stop. I want to stop," he puffed. The man in the signal box saw Percy was in trouble, so kindly set the points. Percy puffed wearily onto a nice empty siding, ending in a big bank of earth. He was too tired now to care where he went. "I want to stop. I want to stop. I have stopped," he puffed thankfully. "Never mind, Percy," said the workman as they dug him out. "You shall have a drink and some coal, and then you'll feel better." Presently, Gordon arrived. "Well done, Percy. You started so quickly that you stopped a nasty accident." "I'm sorry I was cheeky," said Percy. "You were clever to stop." Then Gordon helped pull Percy out from the bank. Percy is still cheeky because he is that sort of engine, but he is always most careful when he goes on the main line.